Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will discuss SAP HANA Analytic View. So, first of all, what is an analytic view? So, my analytic views, they are the star schemas or the fact tables surrounded by the dimensions. So, similar to the schemas, the different schemas in the data warehouse or any other DW concept, so my star schema is something where I have my fact table in between, and after that we have the different dimension tables surrounding it. So my analytical view is basically a star schema where we have the fact table and then we have the dimension table surrounding it. So if we compare it to the SAP BW, so they are roughly compared with the info cubes or the info sets. So my analytical views, they are typically defined on at least one fact table that contains the transactional data along with the number of attributes or the table attribute views or the tables. My analytic views, they leverage the computing power of SAP HANA to compute the aggregate data. For example, if we want to find the number of bikes sold per country or the maximum power consumed per month. So these are the examples of the very common reporting needs which people have, and how the SAP HANA system can calculate the aggregates on for giving these results. Then it is specifically designed to execute the star schema queries. So my analytical views, it is basically designed to execute the star schema queries. Now how we can create the analytic view? So similar to the attribute view, we have to first choose the package under which we want to create the analytical view, and after that we can right click, we can go to the new, and then we can create the analytic view. So now let's log in to the SAP HANA system to see how we can create the analytic view in the HANA Studio. So this is my SAP HANA Studio. Again, first of all, we have to verify that all my tables which I'm going to use in the analytic view, they should exist with data. So we can either use the tables or we can use the attributes view inside the analytic views. So in this example, we will be using the tables. So for that, first of all, we have to go to the catalog, and then we have to go to the schema under which my tables exist. So we will be using the eFashion schema. Under the eFashion schema, we have the tables, and we will be using the three tables inside this, which is my employee DIM. So if I go to the employee DIM, I have the employee ID and the employee name. After that, we will use this employee date, which is my which has my calendar date, calendar month, and the calendar year. Similarly, we will be using the employee fact 1, in which we have my transactional data, which is my salary. And then we have the employee ID and the employee date. So these are the three tables which we will be using in this analytic view. After that, we have to go to the catalog tab, wherein we have to see that the schema and the tables exist. And then we have to create the package, or we can use the existing package under which we can create the analytic view. So we will be using the old package which we have, or which we already have in the system, that is this A1, and then we will create the new analytic view. So we'll go to right click, new, and then we have the analytic view. Again, we have to give the name of the analytic view. So let's say if we give the name as demo underscore analytic underscore view. Now similarly, we can describe the label, and then the package is automatically selected and the view type is automatically selected. Again, we can copy the attribute view, or sorry, copy the analytical view from the existing analytic view. So we can use this copy from option if we want to use the existing view to create the analytic view. After that, we'll click on the finish. So once we'll click on finish, we are able to see the three things here. The first one is the semantic. Semantic is something which is exposed to the end user while creating the reports on SAP HANA views. So after that, we have the star join, So this star join is used when we use another analytic view or the attribute view while creating the analytic view. After that, we have this data foundation wherein we will add all the required tables. So basically, if we use another attribute view to create an analytic view, then we have to use the star join. But if we want to use the tables, the egg multiple tables existing in the HANA system, then we will be using the data foundation. So let's click on the data foundation add object, and then we have to add the objects which we want to use. So first of all, we'll add the employee dimension. After that, we will add employee date, and then we will add our fact table, which is emp fact. So once we have added all the required tables, after that we have to join them. So here in this example, we are using the one fact table, and we have the surrounding dimension table, which are my employee dim and the employee date. So this is somewhat similar to the star schema, and then we have to join them. So we will join the employee ID of my employee dim to the employee ID of my fact table. Similarly, we will join the calendar date of the employee date, and we will add it to the employee date. Now we can double click on the joins, and we can see the properties of the joins. So we can see here that this is a referential join. We can define the cardinality from here. We can validate the join, and then we can click on OK. Similarly, we can click on this join, and we can validate the join, and we can click on OK. So now what we have done is we have added the tables, we have joined them, and then the next step is that we have to add the objects which we want to move to the next layer. So what we will do here is, again, we have to add the objects to the output. So let's say if I want to add the employee name, employee date, employee salary, after that the calendar month. So all these I want to move to the next one. So what we will do here is, we have added all of them to the output. So we can see here that we have the four columns which are added to the output. That is my employee name, employee date, salary, calendar month. So we can see the description of all these properties of all these under my output. Like what is the data type, what is label, what is the mapping. So all these things we can see here. So once we have done that, then we'll click on the star join. So we can see here that all the objects which we have selected from my data foundation, so they are under my star join. They are appearing under my star join. Then we will go to the semantics. So under semantics, we have the options of setting any object as a key. Okay, and then we have the name, we have the label. We can define the aggregation if we want. So here is the type. So now we will see how we can assign the type to a column. So if we select this, we can make it an attribute or we can make it a measure. So my attribute is something which is a characteristic value, and my measure is something which is on which we can do the aggregation. So my salary is my measure, so I will set it as a measure. Similarly, we have this calendar month. So we can either use this option where we can manually set, or there is another option which is a auto assign. So if we click on the auto assign, it will automatically pick up the type from the database. Then we have the aggregation here. So in the aggregation, we have multiple aggregate functions, that is the count, maximum, minimum, and sum. So we can depending on our requirement, we can choose the aggregation here. So once we are done with this, after that we have to save this and we have to activate it. So before that, let's go to the other tabs, that is my properties. So if we go to the properties, we can see here that what is the data category, what is the enable history. So all these things we can see about the view. Similarly, if we want to create the hierarchies, if we want to see the hierarchies, we'll go here and we'll see the hierarchies. And if you want to see the parameters and variables, so we can see under the parameters and variables option. Then we'll go to the columns again, and then we will click on the save and validate. So once we will click on the save and validate, it says that the model validation is done, and then we can activate it. So we'll click on the save and activate, which will activate my model. So no, I don't want to assign it to any change. I'll cancel it, and I can see the activation is done. So we can open up and we can see the results of the activation. So it shows as a success. Now we can use the data preview to see the data into my analytical view. We can click on the data preview here. It will open up the data preview window. So here I can see that I have my employee name, employee date, calendar month, and the salary, right? So we have this option, we can remove it from the value axis, and we have them in the label axis. So we can manually assign it by selecting the object, right clicking, and then we can add them to the label, we can add them to the values, and we can add them to the filters. Now we have the different options here, the different charting options. So if I want to see the data in the form of pie chart, I can click on the pie chart. We have other different types of charts like the box, radar, multiple radar. So depending on the requirement, we can do the analysis on this data. And here we can see the data in the tabular form, we can see the data in the grid form, we can see the HTML view of the data. So these are the different views of the data. After that, if we want to create a filter, then we can create the select the object, we can add it to the filters. And similarly, we can select the values and we can filter the data as per the requirement. So this is how we can create the analytic view. And if we go to this A1 package and if we expand the analytic views, so we will be able to see our demo analytic view existing in this section. So in this tutorial, we have seen how we can create the analytic view, what is the purpose of the analytic view, and we have created one demo analytic view using SAP HANA Studio, which was using the multiple tables, multiple fact, and the dimension table. Thank you.